So, glasses. Remember one of my previous videos where it was what happened in my first hearing aid appointment, and I said something along the lines of they expect to give me another appointment in about 6 weeks. Well, it's been about 3 months, and sure, but I finally got my letter, so let's read it. So this is going to be for a follow-up appointment from my hearing aid fitting. If you want to know more about that, there is a playlist linked up here, and I'll also link that playlist down in the description below. But if you want to stay up to date with hearing aid fittings and future appointments, the best way to do that is to subscribe to my channel and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Okay, cool. Now that's out of the way. The appointment letter. So it's already in my little journal of medical stuff because there's a lot of it, not all hearing related. Dear Max Fisher, good start. This letter is to confirm we are now able to offer you an appointment with clinician, Miss Name, or one of their team. Specialty, audiological medicine. Correct. It is important that you contact us on phone number within 7 days between the hours of 8:30 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. Monday to Friday, so we can arrange a time that suits you best. If you do not contact us, we will assume that you no longer want an appointment with us. Yours sincerely, Nottingham University Hospitals NHS Trust. That's it. So they said, contact us within 7 days. My letter arrived on a Saturday, dated 4 days before that Saturday, which gave me like 1 day to actually make the phone call. And bearing in mind I don't hear brilliantly, the fact that we can't do it via email or like an online booking system, I'm just kind of, look at where you are. So I've made the phone call and I have an appointment on the 18th of October at 10:30 in the morning. So I will see you then. So that went really well. What happened in my second hearing aid appointment? Well, I had a different technician person. I had a different person this time. She was equally as lovely as the last one, actually very helpful and friendly. So we just confirmed all of my identity details. They do that with everyone, every appointment, so that was fun. After all my identity things had been confirmed, I can't speak today. After all my identity things had been confirmed, she looked over the notes from the last appointment. We read through the notes together and sort of discussed them a little bit. And then we talked about if I'd had any problems, how I was getting on with them, and I basically told her that everything was fine, because everything is fine. We had a long discussion about how I'm getting on, am I having any problems, is there anything that I need, have I had to change the tubes yet, do I have enough batteries, that kind of thing. I didn't have enough batteries, I was on my last little packet, so I had my brown book with me, because I was running out of batteries, so I gave this to her and all of my old batteries, because they get you to keep the batteries so you can recycle them when you hand them in. So I gave her all of those, and then let's see what she wrote. I haven't read this yet. This could be interesting. In the back, she wrote all of my battery details, so I have 4 packs of 6. This is illegible. Most of it is illegible, but okay, I know what she wrote. And then in the front was details of the appointment, which I will tell you now. After I'd done all of that, I had to do this thing called a hearing aided test, which is basically a hearing test but with your hearing aids in. You face a speaker and they play 3 rounds of sound. And the first round is quiet speech, so it was about 50 decibels. She said it was at 50, I have to assume it's decibels because that's noises, but there's no background noise, and it'll say small sentences at you, and then you have to repeat them back to her word for word as much as you can, and then you get a score of how many you heard. And then you have round 2, which is can't remember if it was the same volume or not for the speech, but they have little quiet background noise in the background. It's like a whoosh kind of noise, just to see how you fare with your hearing aids in when there's like a little bit of background noise. And then round three is the background noise is the same volume as the speech. It took about 10 minutes, 15 minutes? I don't really know how long it was. I lost track of time, to be quite honest. She was very nice with me writing things down because my memory isn't brilliant because brain fog, because chronic illness. There's a link to another playlist up there explaining all of that mess. The results of this test help me to more accurately describe my hearing and lack thereof and what I'm missing, rather than just kind of guessing based on my experience. I now actually have some stats. So I will tell you this, but I will also talk more about this in a future video that I've got coming up. So when it was just quiet speech with no background noise, I had an accuracy of about 70%, which is, she said, was pretty good. When there was quiet background noise, my accuracy went down to about 50%, which wasn't ideal. When the background noise was the same loudness, the brain fog is strong today, I apologise, but when the background noise was the same as the speech, it went down even further to about 25%, which is not ideal, which is why if you ever go for a drink with me in a pub, I will just nod a lot. I'm working out apps to use to help with that. More on that when I find one that works. She said that obviously it would be ideal to have more hearing than I have in this test, but obviously that isn't how hearing loss works, and that is not how hearing aids work, but she wasn't worried that they were underperforming. She said that that was probably about right, and how do I feel about it, and have I noticed this in my real life situations, which I have. From there we discussed what programs we were going to put on my hearing aids. So as I mentioned in my first hearing aid appointment video, I'll probably put a separate card to that one up there, I mentioned that for now we were only going to have one program so that I could kind of get used to just hearing aids and how they work without having to figure out all the buttons. Well, now it's time to upgrade, so we spoke about what programs I would need and would use. So with the results of the hearing aided test, she suggested that having a speech in noise program would help me out a bit, and I am one of those people that's like, there's no harm in having it and trying it and not liking it. I asked about the music program that was mentioned in my first appointment, and she said candidly that it kind of sucks, but she's happy to put it on for me to try, but don't expect miracles. And I had a little test of it when I got home, and she was right. It was not even a little bit different to my normal program, but it's there should I need it. I'm going to have a look and see what music it works best with, but it's probably nothing that I listen to. We unplugged them, I put them back in my head, and we had like a little flick through, like test the button, make sure it works, see what noise it makes for what program, that kind of thing. And then I inquired about a T-loop. I said, oh, do they have a T-loop? Because in a lot of labs they use a radio system, so I was thinking that that might help. And she was like, it doesn't, but I can put one on. Give me the hearing aids back. And I was like, sorry, should have asked that question before. And she was completely fine with it, because sometimes that just happens. Then we put a T-loop on it and discussed how that kind of works a little bit, like a little bit of information here and there, how it might work. And then she said, you can get T-loop kind of ear hooks, so that they're kind of like earphones, but they go through your hearing aids, and they use the T-loop to do that. So I asked, what device do I need for that? And the catalog's over there. She showed me in the catalog which products would work with my hearing aids, and I wrote down the page number, and I have just ordered a pair of hearing aid hooks. So when they arrive, I will test those out and see how we go. So I'm really excited to be able to like listen to music through my hearing aids instead of having to over the earphones, which are really expensive. She made sure I had everything that I needed if I had any more questions, any more queries, which I didn't because I've been getting on with my hearing aids really, really well. And then she released me back into the wild. She said my next appointment will be in about a year, so I guess I will see you then for that. Overall, my second hearing aid fitting went really, really well. I can go back at any time if I need any more adjustments, if I get an ear infection, if my hearing loss changes, if I need any more programs putting on, if I want any taking off. Any sort of adjustment, I can book in for an appointment and go, otherwise they will see me in a year. I hope this has been helpful for you. I know when I was starting this journey I had a lot of anxiety about each appointment because I couldn't find anything online about what would happen. So I made some. So I hope this has helped. Don't forget to like this video if you have enjoyed it, if it has been helpful for you. Drop a comment with anything I might have missed. If you have any questions, I'm happy to answer those. And while you're down there, subscribe to my channel for more videos on hearing loss, as well as chronic illness, cold urticaria, cats, whatever I feel like filming. And ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. with at least one bonus video every single month. See ya!